A low-pressure area east of Infanta Quezon is affecting the southwest monsoon and bringing rains over parts of the country. Let's get more details now from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Chanel, over to you.
Good afternoon. So today, the low-pressure area was estimated based on all available data at 160 kilometers east-northeast of Infanta Quezon. This low-pressure area is likely to develop into a tropical depression within the next 48 hours. And with the combined effect of the LPA and the enhanced southwest monsoon, it may bring rains over Metro Manila, the rest of Luzon, Visayas, Zamboanga Peninsula, northern Mindanao, Caraga, and Barm. Expect this rain to last the whole day, and here in Davao region and Soccsaygan, expect a generally fair weather with the chances of rain too due to southwest monsoon. And that's the latest here in PAGASA forecasting. Chanel Dominguez, and good afternoon.
Yes, Chanel, may isang tanong lang ako sa'yo. Yung nangyari kagabi na talagang heavy downpour, no? Especially here in Metro Manila, ito ba ay senyales ng kung ano pang pwedeng mangyari dahil sa El Nino phenomenon?
Dahil wala pong ikinalaman po yung El Nino po dito po sa disturbances na nangyayari po sa ngayon.
Opo, pero yung pagbuhos po ng ganun kalakas na ulan, ganun din ho ba ang aasahan kapag nagkaroon ng freak weather or downpour dulot ng El Nino?
Yes po, kasi po nasa panahon po tayo ng tag-ulan, so asahan po talaga natin na mag-prevail po ang hanging habagat.
All right, maraming salamat. Chanel Dominguez there, our PAGASA weather forecaster. Thanks for joining us this afternoon. All right, let's get an update on the water level of dams that have been drying up in recent days. Joining us now is PAGASA hydrologist Richard Orendain. Richard, good afternoon to you, and thank you for joining us today.
Yes, good afternoon.
All right, so when it comes to the heavy downpour that we experienced last night, was that enough to replenish the dams that's been losing a lot of water? Go ahead.
Okay. For Angat Dam elevation, as of 6 a.m. is 178.03. Bumaba siya ng 18 centimeter. Although, may mga pagulan within the watershed ng Angat Dam. Approximately 43 millimeters of rainfall, that is basin average. Mm-hmm. So, halos nice slowdown niya yung pagbaba ng Angat Dam, dahil for the record, halos nag-average siya ng 35 to 45 centimeter per day yung pagbaba ng Angat Dam. But dahil nga...
Richard? Okay, we're going to try and get Richard back on the line soon as we can. But hydrologist Richard Orendain there telling us that... the rains that happened last night was not enough to replenish the water that's been lost in the past days. It was able, though, to slow down the water from going down in these dams. I think we have him back on the line, PAGASA hydrologist Richard Orendain. Richard, pasensya na, naputol tayo.
Yes,
you were saying? Go ahead. So hindi na-replenish yung mga nawalang tubig in the past weeks, pero bumagal ang pagbaba ng tubig.
Yes, ma'am. Dahil nga ito sa mga pag-ulan kagabi, na nag-record tayo ng 43 millimeters na basin average rainfall. So, na-slow down niya yung pagbaba, dahil on the average, 35 to 45 centimeter ang ibinababa ng Angat Dam per day kung wala talaga mga pag-ulan.
Mm-hmm.
But then, 18 centimeter lang yung ibinaba niya sa ngayong araw na to, for the past 24 hours. So, malaking bagay yung inulan kagabi. And we're expecting na kung ma-reach ng basin average of about 70 millimeters of rainfall, po pwedeng umabot ang Angat Dam sa 180 meters, or po pwede na siya maging normal high water level, or mas mataas na siya doon sa minimum operating level na 180 meters.
Mm-hmm. Pero kakausap lang namin kay Chanel Dominguez. Diyan din po sa inyo, diyan sa PAGASA, ang sinasabi niya, itong sama ng panahon, it's just gonna last for the next 48 hours. Tingin niyo ba sapat yun na panahon para mabalik sa dati ang level ng tubig dito sa Angat Dam?
Yes po, may possibility kasi yung ulan nga kagabi na umabot siya ng 43 millimeters on the average. kumbaga, ganun din yung scenario na maging 43 millimeters on the average yung iuulan sa ngayong araw na to. And may mga additional inflow pa na hindi pa nakakarating sa reservoir na inulan kagabi. So, may possibility na tumaas ang Angat Dam tomorrow or by Saturday.
Mm-mm. Pero kung halimbawa ma-reach nga natin yung normal level within the next 48 hours, no? Gaan at pero magpatuloy na naman ang init ng panahon, gaano kaya katagal itatagal itong nakuha nating tubig mula sa tubig ulan?
Well, siguro tatagal pa rin yan ng mga aabot ng mga 5 to 7 days kung ma-reach na yung peak ng pagtaas sa ngayong umuulan siya. Siguro tatagal siya ng mga 5 to 7 days na naman bago na naman bumaba itong level ng tubig natin.
Mm-hmm.
Dahil ang travel time from upstream ng reservoir is umaabot siya ng 18 to 24 hours bago makarating doon sa reservoir, kaya medyo matagal-tagal din.
Opo, pero parang isang linggo, that's not enough, ano? Kapag patuloy pa rin yung behavior, consuming behavior, no, ng ating mga consumers at patuloy pa rin yung init ng panahon, that's not going to that's going to be quite a short time as well. Kahit na isang linggo yan, kailangan pa rin magkaroon po ng interventions kahit papaano.
Well, sa ngayon kasi kung like for example magka-cloud seeding tayo, hindi kasi advisable ngayon, ma'am, kasi tag-ulan tayo ngayon. So sayang naman yung gagastusin natin sa cloud seeding. Why not hintayin na lang natin yung talagang mga pag-ulan.
Okay. Maraming salamat po, Richard Orendain, our hydrologist there in Pag-asa. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. Ingat po. Well, heavy rains also led to floods in Cebu City. Annie Perez now joins us with an update from there. Annie, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, the Cebu City Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office are working double time to clear the roads that were impassable yesterday due to flood. Debris are still scattered in the city today. Heavy downpour occurred late in the afternoon and it is also raining now as we speak. Netizens were quick to share videos of the roads that looked like a river due to knee-deep floods. CCDRRMO logged about 7 flooded areas that included Barangay Careta to Dayas, Sitio San Roque and Bayanihan in Barangay Mangaling, Colon Street, Gorordo Avenue in Lahok, Tipadilla Street, and Bonifacio Street. They are also telling motorists to drive safely because of the flood. Councilor Jerry Guardo, who is the chair for the Committee on Infrastructure, revisited a flood control project earlier this morning in Barangay Tejero and asked the workers to expedite this so as to avoid the flood that happened yesterday, and most residents are also expecting the same in the coming days. Many were stranded and had to wade through the waters to get to their destinations. A landslide was also logged at Sitio Cambios in Barangay Sirao, a mountain barangay in Cebu City, which the residents and even the disaster responders believe to be rain-triggered. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa and its Mactan Station said that the low-pressure area is affecting the southwest monsoon, bringing rains over the Visayas as its trough is causing partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and thunderstorms causing heavy rains. There are also light to moderate winds now in the Visayas, Carmina, from west to southwest, which will result to slight to moderate seas. But as of now, we don't have word yet from the Philippine Coast Guard if there are any affected ferry and trips in any of the ports here in Cebu and other areas of Central Visayas. And that's the latest. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Heavy rains batter the province of Samar, flooding several villages. In San Andres Village, residents were evacuated as floodwaters reached the second floor of some homes. The local government is providing aid to affected residents. Over in Yabong, Samar, heavy rains also inundated farms. Damage assessment is underway. Well, residents and small businesses in parts of Metro Manila scramble to store water as concessionaire Maynilad starts implementing daily water interruptions amid tight supply. Vivian Guglia reports.
Water containers lined up outside a water refilling station in Navota City hours before Maynilad begins implementing daily water service interruptions Wednesday night. Among those who went for a refill is Concepcion.
Mahirap na pag naubusan ng tubig, kaya nag-iipon.
The Navota City Hospital has issued a memo advising staff to conserve water amid the onset of El Nino. But the hospital management issues assurance its water tanks are sufficient to support uninterrupted services for the duration of the nightly water interruption.
Yung 3 tanks po natin na naka-prepare, eh, nagla-last po ito ng 4 days if in case totally makakut off po yung supply ng water. Continue lang po ang services namin.
Pinag-aaralan namin na paano makapagbawas sa tubig na hindi naapektuhan yung trabaho namin. Magamit po kami minsan ng mga equipment ng mga chemical na lang po namin katulad ng air freshener.
The Navota City government says water tankers from the Bureau of Fire and volunteer organizations are on standby to ration water if needed.
Mga residents naman, any concern po nila, 24 hours nandyan po yung ating text JRT, nandyan yung social media na may nagbabantay at yung mga hotlines po natin. So pwede silang tumawag para makadala tayo ng tulong.
In Caloocan City, some residents have adjusted the schedule for activities that use plenty of water, like cleaning the house, doing the laundry, and bathing.
Maglilinis ako minsan gabi. Kasi mainit, di ba? Mga 7, ganun.
Pero ngayon?
Eh, maaga ako dahil sabi mga 7 mawawalan, di ba?
Siguro kailangan lahat makaligo na before 5 o'clock. So yung mga naka-store, hindi na siya magagalaw unless mag-CR lang talaga. So lahat ng kasama namin sa bahay, alam na yon.
In Malabon City, a store selling water to fish vendors in the market expressed concern the daily water service interruptions will affect his sales since the business is busiest between 8 p.m. and 4 a.m.
Ang bagay po, pandagdag po sa ano po yun, sa kita ng tubig. Wala po kasing pupwesto yun pagka maraming drum. Kasi mamaya po, puno po na tindahan is dahil mamaya. Magdadagdag po mamaya po. Mga 2 drum.
Nearly 600,000 Maynilad customers in 6 Metro Manila cities are expected to experience 9 to 11-hour daily water service interruptions. It is scheduled to start every 7 p.m. in parts of Quezon City, Caloocan, Malabon, Valenzuela, Navotas, and Manila. This comes as Angat Dam Reservoir's water level continues to fall below the minimum operating level of 180 meters for the 5th straight day. On Wednesday morning, it was at 178.21 meters.
Itong binigay sa atin na alokasyon na 48 cubic meters per second, konti na ang nakakarating na supply dito sa ating treatment plant sa Quezon City. So ibig sabihin dahil konti na yung supply, kapos na siya sa pangangailangan ng Maynilad para mapanatili po yung normal na servisyo ng tubig sa ating concession area.
Maynilad says it targets to reduce the hours of water service interruptions.
Dahil meron tayong additional supply naman na nakukuha sa ating supply augmentation projects, mag-improve dapat ito as long as the allocation remains the same. Pwedeng, for example, in some areas, 8 p.m. mag-umpisa or 9 p.m. Again, depending on the availability of water in our treatment plants.
Maynilad has yet to give a timeline on until when the water service interruptions will last, but Rufo says it could stay as long as allocation for water concessionaires from Angat Dam is at 48 cubic meters per second. Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.